During a supervisory visit by officials from USMIT, World Bank, the Ministry of Lands, Housing and Urban Development and Kabale Municipality on April 25th this year, the contractor was given up to until August 3rd this year to substantially complete its road upgrading projects in Kabale Municipality or risk losing its contract. The contractor is Multiplex Construction Company Limited. However, in Kabale Municipality, despite the three extensions granted, the construction work progress remains at 26.4%, with the contractor leveling the roads and digging trenches to work on the drainage system. Contractors are accused of being unserious and mobilizing machinery and workers only on days when supervisors are expected to visit. Patricia Achan Okiria, the Deputy Inspector General of the government, directed that charging of liquidated damages and the move to terminate contracts awarded to the company be halted until they receive further communication from the same office. When contacted, Achan confirmed the development, saying that the directive is because the IGG has commenced investigations into the matter after the contractor lodged a complaint accusing municipality authorities of mistreatment.
Not that I'm defending Multiplex. Multiplex is the complainant, and the matter needs to be investigated because there are issues the complainant raises to do with the cause of the delay. The design of the project, the design of the road was to be done by the district officials, and they needed to have done due diligence before. But now they are saying they want to terminate the contract because of the delay, which delay they caused themselves. So for us, we are doing an investigation. I've asked them to halt any activity on it. We investigate and find out who exactly is responsible for the delay.
Emmanuel Sentaro Biamgisha, the Kabale Municipality Mayor, told our reporter that his office has received a copy of the letter directing them to neither terminate the contract nor demand for liquidation damages from the contractor.
After getting this chance of implementing a presidential pledge, the contractor we are having is seen to be protected by some of the structures of government, some officials from government, who should be, by the way, pushing this contractor to execute the works and the finishing time.
Biamgisha wonders why the IGG rushes to issue a directive favoring the contractor and forgets that the whole phase of USMIT Cluster 6 is ending in December this year.
On internal inefficiencies with regards to recruitment and retention of qualified personnel, project planning, cash flow management, and the work resource management for the works, the contractor rarely has and adheres to an updated resource work program. The contractor has a very high turnover of project engineers, resulting in lack of technical command.
Locals in the area where the project is being implemented are not satisfied with the progress so far, since it has affected their businesses.
This project also is concerned. We are excited, I must say. We are heavily excited and we are deeply indebted about this project. But unfortunately, somewhere we lost morale. To the extent that among the beneficiaries here around, they have some, even though they see people working, they have somehow given up.
According to the contractor, several challenges have affected their capability to deliver on time.
To accumulate material in a very short time. It's a pity that the issue of NEMA regarding the stone quarry has not been mentioned and it has never been appreciated as a cause of delay. Even when we have been getting extensions, it has never been looked into.
Report by Job Namanya for the news.